her mind. Seductive, alluring, hot, beautiful. Some even say she is the sexiest woman in Hollywood. Well, after tonight, you may want to add to that image, because there is another side to this actress who is known to arouse basic instincts. As Lynn Scherr found out, what you see is what you get, plus a whole lot more.
Even off-screen, the mystery persists. There is something dangerous going on here. Someone untouchable, enigmatic. Above all, a woman definitely worth pursuing. You have to catch up with her to appreciate the illusion, to see how much the real Sharon Stone remains fused with her movie image.
What do you think is the public perception of you?
I think of it as the public perception of her.
Of her.
That's how it's become.
Her being Sharon Stone?
Yes. Okay. Because it was at a certain point, it was still related to simply whatever I did or didn't do. Then there was a point where it jumped off. And I read endless stories about all these things that she did and people she knows and is having affairs with and going places with. It's like, wow, she's having an interesting life.
So who is she, as far as you can tell?
She's kind of slutty and wild and...
Slutty. Does that apply to you?
No, I'm pretty... I'm very, very monogamous and personally shy. I think that's why I like playing some of these bigger-than-life characters and just really letting it rip, because, you know, there aren't any consequences. I thought.
Stone claims she had no idea how much her role in Basic Instinct as a bisexual sociopathic killer would shape her image. It made her the screen's leading seductress, a star who courted danger. And it made Basic Instinct some $350 million in 1992.
Did you kill Mr. Boz, Miss Trammell?
I'd have to be pretty stupid to write a book about
that. That was largely thanks to the eye-popping interrogation scene. An R-rated sequence where Stone bared a part of her body not usually shown on television.
It's nice. You know, there are things that I did in that movie and things that happened that I had no idea were going to be as they were.
Were you embarrassed?
Shocked. And it was like the bottom fell out. Angry. So... just so shocked.
But you had done it. I mean, it wasn't as if...
Well, yeah.
No one held a gun to your head.
Well, no. I thought it was a great idea for the character. I never thought it was being shot so explicitly or would be revealed so explicitly. And my life changed. And I think because I had the sort of brazen guts to do it, I think people identified me as that woman, because if I wasn't that woman, how could I do that thing?
That woman started out near Erie, Pennsylvania, growing up in a small rural town with a blue-collar family. While there was no hint of the future femme fatale, her very progressive father early planted the seeds of independence.
My father was very strong with me and very specific with me as a child. You know, when I would be out playing with the other kids, he would call me over and he'd say, "You're letting that boy win because he's a boy. Why are you doing that? You're probably better at this than he is. Why are you letting him win?"
That advice led to a self-reliance that paid off academically. Young Sharon was a smart kid who excelled in advanced classes. But with thick glasses and a skinny body, socially, she says, she was a geek.
I wanted to fit in. I wanted to have a date. I wanted to be like other kids. I didn't have a date to the prom. And that is about the time I started to realize that I could reinvent myself and be very different. So I bought fashion magazines and I gained some weight and, you know, bought some tight jeans and some high heels and dyed my hair and got contact lenses and went to college.
Hi, I'm Sharon Stone. This is Crawford County. I'm presently a sophomore at Edinburgh State College, majoring in art education.
The transformation was an amazing success. She modeled in New York, then broke into movies in 1980, with an amusing, wordless role in Woody Allen's Stardust Memories. Nearly a decade later, she was kissing more than windows in Total Recall, honey, as the menacing wife of Arnold Schwarzenegger.
After all, we're married.
Hollywood swooned over its sexy new star, but Sharon Stone added a dimension to the old-time glamour girls, an uncompromising 90s take on women's real-life roles.
Do you think you ever suffered from sex discrimination?
Yeah. And tall blonde discrimination and, you know.
Oh, talk about that.
Anything.
Yes, talk about tall blonde discrimination.
Well, you know, it's very funny because I've just made my hair very blonde again for the next picture. And instantly, in a two-day period, you know, people started treating me like my IQ's dropped to room temperature. It's just unbelievable. It's like, you know, aren't you Sharon Stone? I'm like,
is it difficult to be an intelligent woman in Hollywood?
Okay, I'm just gonna say it. I think it's difficult to be an intelligent woman.
Because I think
you pay. I think that a lot of women act dumb, and it really peeves me. Because every time a woman goes out and acts dumb, it makes it harder for me and harder for you. And I don't like it.
Stone won't call herself a feminist, but openly embraces many of its principles.
In society, women are taught to behave in certain ways, to make that agreement. You can be powerful, you can get your way, but you have to cry. You have to be a girl. You have to make it happen. You know, it's like, I don't get that. I can't do that.
Here's what she can do. Take charge and generate the kind of cinematic heat that made her the only choice to co-star with Sylvester Stallone in the new release, The Specialist. One scene was almost too hot to handle.
We have a thing where the building we're in is blowing up, and as we're going, it's actually blowing up around us. But blowing up so you could feel the heat of the fire. You know, I was deathly afraid that it was just going to melt my costume to my skin. And he was, you know, this guy was like, come on, you know, I do this, I run through helicopters and things. Just trust me, baby. Yeah, okay, yeah, come on, Jim, we're just going to run down the hallway. And, you know, it's like really not like it's okay.
Stone's last two movies, Sliver and Intersection, fell far short of the huge audiences drawn by Basic Instinct. Still, here in the Hollywood Hills, it's clear she remains a star and a major draw, even at her advanced age.
I'm 36. I'm not gonna be thought of as a sex symbol for a whole lot longer. I'm watching the butt slide down the legs and, you know, the eyelids have like two folds now. I'm up to speed on it.
Do you think you can be a sex symbol at 50?
I think it's good to be allowed to be attractive when you're 40, 50, 60, and 70. I think it's good to be allowed to be sexually viable. And if people think that's dangerous, great.
That attitude is now earning her a reported $4 million per picture.
When you spend money on yourself, what do you buy?
Oh, stupid stuff, you know. Very expensive night cream. Then I put it on my legs and go, ha, ha, ha.
Any woman who could laugh at herself can't be that dangerous, right? Still, mystery remains part of her mystique. And Sharon Stone is well aware that she pays a price for her sensual celebrity. Divorced after a brief marriage to a film producer, she told me she doesn't want children just now because of her career. And she admitted that her reputation has forced her into a cocoon. When she discusses the private side of fame, her face actually changes.
What frightens me a lot is when people associate me with her and have peculiar reactions to it.
Her?
Mm-hmm. That public image, that thing, sometimes enervates people and sometimes creates peculiar responses in ways that I am not equipped to deal with because I am not her.
Do you have trouble with fans that way? Have you been stalked, for instance?
Well, something I'd really rather not get into because I don't like to validate the negative. But suffice it to say, it's not all a bed of daisies.
You said before something about the fame has made you feel more responsible.
Well, yes. I mean, I think that there is an ethical responsibility to being in the public eye. If everybody's looking at you, you better make sure you know what you're doing.
Some women have said, maybe you're the wrong image for women because you use your sexuality. And
you know what? Maybe they should do it. It's a big job. I could use some help. Come on. We'll all do it. You do it your way, I'll do it my way. I think that was the way it was intended. I can't help it. They're looking at me right now. All I can do is do it my way. If some people find that inspiring or great, great. If some people don't, great. Then they'll look at someone else.
What, if anything, would you like people to know about you that they don't know already?
Nothing. You know enough. Get lost.
She's a good lady. I like her. I interviewed her, as you know.
I agree, yes, indeed.
I liked her a lot. But, you know, this is no overnight sensation, as you and I know. She did this. Basic Instinct was her 18th film, and before that, there was a lot of schlock.
There were, indeed.
She paid her dues.
But, you know, the irony, Barbara, is that Basic Instinct, which is the movie that made her such a star, that's the image she's trying so hard to get away from. The question is, will the audience let her play somebody other than a dangerous woman?
Yeah.
You know what she told me, what she wants to play?
What?
On stage, Mame, singing and dancing.
Yeah, but Mame is sexy.
Well, yeah, but do you think we're ready for Mame with an ice pick?
I'm not sure, but if anyone can do it, she can.
I agree. She's terrific.
Thank you. We'll be right back.
This month, when you come to Walmart, look for this big old thank you card.
Thanks for saving at Walmart.
And look for low prices on thousands of items throughout the store.
Thanks for saving at Walmart.
It's our way of thanking you for 32 years of friendship. And we'll be thanking you with extra low prices throughout the month of October.
It's our 32nd anniversary, and we wouldn't be here without you. So we'd just like to say,
thanks for saving with us.
Introducing the new Mercury Mystique. It has available all-speed traction control, a micron air filter that removes dust and pollen, and a 24-valve Duratec V6 engine that goes 100,000 miles before its first scheduled tune-up. Yet even though Mystique is equipped like a luxury car, it's priced thousands less than cars in its own class. Because the last time we looked, money still doesn't grow on trees. The all-new Mystique. It's a whole new Mercury.
Maybe no one ever told you that you are a healer. There is no stronger medicine than the power of your words. No touch softer than the sound of your voice. No bitter remedy for bruised feelings and broken hearts. Introducing Time Bank. Only Time Bank awards you one free minute for every 5 you spend on the phone. It's about time we were recognized for something we do so well.
You know what really gets under my skin?
Your boss?
No, my athlete's foot. Say this is my foot.
Athlete's foot doesn't just happen from between my toes. It grows down in here, just below the skin's surface. That's why I use Mycotin. Mycotin's serious stuff. It penetrates to kill the fungus where it grows. With Mycotin, I don't just get relief, I get cured. When athlete's foot gets under your skin, get Mycotin. cure that gets in.
ABC News 2020 will continue in a moment. The Pittsburgh Steelers tackle the Houston Oilers on ABC's Monday Night Football. Then it's an all-new coach when Hayden goes south of the border. He feels down under.
You're the one who had to order something fancy.
A taco?
Then Russell is dating a model, a lingerie model.
Recognized her from the Victoria's Secret catalog. It's very popular in prison.
An all-new Blue Skies following coach and Monday Night Football here on ABC.
Emmy award-winning show that changed the face of television begins a stunning new season.
I'm always gonna love you.
I'd like to resume seeing you.
Will the defendant please rise?
NYPD Blue premieres October 11th. Viewer discretion advised.
Cod. Skipper starts with deep sea cod. Then we bake it right. Tender and delicious. And the entire meal has just 4.5 grams of fat and 289 calories. Will that bring you back?
Definitely.
We thought so. Baked right, priced right. That's new baked cod. That's seafood's new attitude. At Skipper's, what'll bring you back?
How could we conclude this week without a word or two, at least, about the O.J. Simpson trial? The jury pool was narrowed down to 304 this week, from which 12 jurors and 8 alternates will be chosen. And all of these prospective jurors have filled out an extensive questionnaire, 75 pages of questions, which hint at the arguments you may be hearing during the trial. For example, questions like this: when is violence an appropriate response to domestic trouble? Have you ever felt sufficiently frustrated within a domestic relationship that you considered violence? Do you own any special knives other than cooking, such as hunting or pen knives, and so forth? Well, Judge Lance Ito has not yet decided whether to sequester the jury, and that would mean the jurors would not be allowed home for perhaps months. Their mail and phone calls would be monitored, and conjugal visits would be banned. Defense lawyers argue that by trial's end, O.J. Simpson would be facing what they call scorpions in a bottle if that happened.
That sounds right, doesn't it? Defense attorney Johnny Cochran told us that if he had his druthers, he might prefer an old woman jury. He says women are more instinctive, and he apparently feels their instinct would be to sympathize with Simpson. Remember, in the trial of Eric Menendez, all the women jurors voted for the lesser charge of manslaughter and not murder. There have also been suggestions of some backstage drama, competition within Simpson's defense team, specifically between Robert Shapiro, so far still the lead lawyer, and the genial Johnny Cochran, who seems to be gaining Simpson's confidence more and more. It will be interesting to see who actually tries the case. And finally, so many people these days claim to be a close friend of O.J. or Nicole Simpson's, but next week we will talk with several of the people everyone agrees were Nicole's closest friends, including the wife of Olympic athlete Bruce Jenner. Kris Jenner spoke with us about the relationship between Nicole and O.J.
Was O.J. jealous?
O.J. was jealous. O.J. was jealous of the people that she would associate herself with if they were male, and he didn't really know them. It took him a while. It took him a while to get used to the fact that she was now dating, and she had every right to go out and date. She was divorced.
You'll hear things never revealed before. Was there someone else in Nicole's life at the time she was murdered? Was O.J. stalking her? The answers next week. We'll be right back.
It takes so little to save our waters for future generations. Using less toxic household cleaners and fewer lawn care chemicals protects so much. Help stop water pollution forever. Clean water. If we all do a little, we can do a lot.
It offers all-speed traction control, a 24-valve Duratec V6 engine that goes 100,000 miles before its first scheduled tune-up, and is engineered to deliver a ride you have to experience to believe. Introducing the all-new Mercury Mystique. When we created this car, we pulled out all the stops. The all-new Mystique. It's a whole new Mercury.
Now it's time to check in with Nightline. Forrest Sawyer, who's sitting in for Ted Koppel, has a preview of tonight's program.
Tonight on Nightline, there was a time black Americans dreamed of being fully integrated with white America. Now the reality of that integration is causing...